Hello, this is Bern, and if you're a single woman and you've not been able to create the relationship that you want, on today's episode, I'm going to be sharing with you some life principles that can allow you to create a path so that this becomes a reality for you starting today. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your greatlifeview.com. A space where I share with ambitious, heart-centered, driven, and conscious women how you can create the relationship of your dreams as a result of stepping into the most alive and most feminine version of yourself without the need of manipulation, games, techniques, or silly tactics. Now, today is one of those days where if I generally focus on things that transcend the specific techniques, today is a day where I even step a little bit further back and give you some life principles that can create the relationship that you want, and beyond the relationship that you want, impact virtually every area of your life. The first one is the principle that I'd love for you to step into and start mastering is delayed gratification. What does this mean? This means not just the ability to invest time, energy, right now to get something better in the future, but the ability to experience short-term pain to get much more of what you want in the future. Specific example would be where you take longer to meet a man before you get intimate with him. That's delayed gratification. Where you take the time to do the hard work of forgiveness right now so that when the opportunity arises, you are not carrying around pain in your heart and you can evaluate that man for who he is instead of the 10 guys that have come before him that you feel a grudge against. The late gratification is having more discipline to do the things you need to do to get to feel what you want to feel when you don't feel like doing it. Does that make sense? It's like when you need to exercise and you don't want to do it, but you do it and then you feel great afterwards. It's kind of the same thing. How can you step into the life that you want right now, even when it's the hard thing to do, even when you could be doing other things that are more relaxed and in the short term, more fulfilling, but that don't seed the kind of results that you really want in your life. So having the virtue of discipline and delayed gratification are the amazing start for the kind of relationship you want and also for the kind of life that you ultimately want to experience in other areas. Second is a combination of two things. One is radical honesty. Second one is heart clarity, which are similar. Radical honesty means the ability to let yourself know what you really want, let yourself know where you really are, and use whatever excitement and whatever punchy in the stomach pain you know from not being where you want to be to drive you to a new destination, to drive you to new action, to drive you to get the resources you need, to drive you to experience a different kind of life. The more honest you are with yourself, the better and the faster you can get yourself to a new place if where you are right now is not where you want to go. Third principle that I want for you to learn to master is the ability to turn pain into strength. This is so hard because pain ultimately has this loop where you could get into a feeling of helplessness or shame or a feeling of victimhood or a feeling of not being able to get the results you want because of the pain that you experience. I'm not saying that it's easy, and I'm not saying that there's going to be times in your life where you honestly are a victim of something or someone. The thing today is, what will you do about it? How can you use that pain into your advantage to transcend, to transmute, to alchemize the pain into strength, into courage, into action, into showing up more for yourself, into paving a path for future generations to be able to break through their own fears and insecurities. So the more you're able to look back at the past and step into transcending pain into strength, the more powerful the kind of relationship you can step into, because instead of carrying a story about why you can't open up to a man, why you can't experience aliveness, why you can't experience vulnerability, you use that same past to have more to share, more to give, and obviously making different decisions, including taking more time to get to know someone, including only opening up more and more as the man that you're connecting with shows you in principle and in action that he is who he says he is and that his intentions are clearly to step into love versus self-service. Number four, a celebration of your individuality. So that means the mastery of celebrating your individuality means that there's going to be areas of your life and areas of your personality and areas of your soul that expressed seem weird, seem different, seem to not conform to what the majority of the world is seeking or expressing. And instead of saying, I'm going to turn my heart, my experience, myself into this vanilla version that fits into the mold of other human beings, that you allow yourself to celebrate your uniqueness, celebrate the areas that make you different, and instead of shying away from them, that you can double down and say, I embrace them with my full heart, and I'm able to not just accept them, but to praise them and love them. If there's something about you, from the way you move, the way you dress, the way you speak, ideas that you have about the world that are different but still powerful, that you allow yourself to value them and honor them and not try to make yourself into everybody else. Don't want to turn yourself into an Instagram fucking version of yourself that means nothing to no one, that on paper looks good, but when you push comes to shove, it doesn't translate into human connection. Fifth virtue is expressiveness. Is once you are able to step into the few of the other ones that I shared, to pain into strength, celebration of your being unique and different, delayed gratification, that you're able to express what's in your heart, that you're able to express your truth, that you're able to express your voice, that you're able to express the excitement you have and also the anger when it's something that's unjust or something that's not, that's crossing a boundary, that you're able to be an expressive force of what's inside of you so that people around you have an understanding of your inner world and also can feel a stronger sense of connection with you. Because if you're expressing more of who you are, two things will happen. Some people will look at you and say, I hate this woman. Some people will look at you and say, I adore this woman. You will have less gray area, but those who resonate with you will be all in. Those who don't resonate with you will self-disqualify themselves, but you're not going to be treading in the middle as this quasi version of yourself that doesn't stick or resonate with anyone. Last one is pretty difficult, but it's so important to step into, and that's self-awareness. Self-awareness as to what you, your energy, how, what impact does your energy have to people around you? The more you can step into the learning, the practicing, the embodiment of these skills that in no way am I saying that they're easy to step into, but the more you can step into them, the better chance and the higher quality of relationship you have the possibility of entering. Hope you find this skills that are not necessarily gimmicks, that are not necessarily something easy that you can just check off the box in this cosmopolitan six things you can do today to change your life. These are things that are gonna require energy, they're gonna require vision, they're gonna require discipline, they're gonna require time, but they can help you step into the better relationship than the ones you've been in the past, and also a better quality of life. If you find this is helpful, useful, insightful, I'm gonna ask you to do three things, my dear. Number one, thing number one, click like on this video. Thing number two, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. And if you don't wanna miss an episode, click the little bell so you're notified of new episodes. Thing number three, if you feel this is helpful and you wanna take it to the next level and want to learn more about how you can step into the kind of relationship you want in a more practical sense, less abstract, then there's a free masterclass I created for you that you can click on the first link in the description of this video, and you'll be taken to a page where you just enter your name and email, and it's gonna start playing this masterclass for you for free. Last but not least, if you're saying, Bern, I love the videos, I resonate with what you're saying, I need more than something detached like a video. I want specific hand-holding, specific mentorship to get out of my own shit and to step into the best relationship of my life, and I feel you can be that person for me, well, there's another link under the description of this video that will allow you to apply for a conversation with me where if we're fit, we can start working together. If we're not fit, no harm done. If you feel this application I feel can help you, my assistant will reach out to schedule a time with you. If I feel I can't help you, we'll let you know as well. Thank you so much for connecting with me as always. We challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.